Hi there, it's Rolando, and welcome back to Answer the Community, where I answer your questions. And today we're tackling the PolySync 20 and the Sync 40 speakerphones. As you may know, Poly has released a new line of speakerphones, including the Sync 20, the Sync 40, and the Sync 60. Today we're not highlighting the 60, we're focusing in on the Sync 40, as well as comparing that to the earlier release of the Sync 20. Before we get started, I want to invite you to bump the like button, hit subscribe, so we can bring you more of these types of videos. So let's take a look at what you get inside the box of the Sync 40. You get this nice blue box that says Sync 40 right on the front. And the Sync 40 comes in two versions. One version comes with a Bluetooth dongle, which I've got here on the side, and that is sold either separately if you don't need the Bluetooth dongle, or it also comes included depending on the version that you're purchasing. I just want to also note that we also provide a microfiber cloth so that you're able to clean your glasses or whatever else that you want to clean, your screen, or even the actual Sync 40 should you get some stuff on it. So let's take a look at what's inside this box. So you'll see you get a quick start guide. And there's all the legalese. If you like some easy reading at night, you get that included as well. It should come wrapped in plastic. Let's take this out of the box. As you can see, it's got quite a bit of a nice look and feel to it. It's got a nice kind of denim look on the front. Instead of your standard black, it's got their volume up and down. You've got a mute button. And there is another version as well that includes a Teams specific button. And that is for those folks that are real heavy users of Microsoft Teams. And if you are a user of Microsoft Teams, you want the PolySync 40 version that is designed specifically for Microsoft Teams. So let me move this box out of the way. Let's take a look at this here on the table. This is what the Sync 40 looks like. It comes with this cable. And you have a cable that allows you to use it both for USB-A, which is this connector here, or, and if you have a newer style connector, it comes with a USB-C. Let me unwrap it from here. So you can see you get quite a bit of distance here with this cable. And these are the two connectors, USB-A and USB-C. So no need to purchase a separate connector if you've got the newer USB-C standard. The Sync 40 is also a Bluetooth device, so you'll be able to use it with your phone or PC. Now, for those users that are going to use it with PC, it is highly recommended to either use the USB connection or go ahead and use it with the dongle. You're going to get much better audio quality, you get a better performance, and you'll be happier for the stable connection that you get when you use a USB Bluetooth dongle. We also have a Bluetooth extender, so if you plan on using it with the dongle and you want to maybe move it into a conference room or more than 10 feet away from the PC that you're using it, links are below to the Bluetooth Blue Beacon extender to give you a little bit of extra range and a better quality signal. So we've got the Sync 40 and as well the entry level model, the Sync 20. The big difference is the size. So you're going to get a size difference between the 40, which is really designed mainly for medium sized rooms, or if you want a little more oomph in volume, the 40 works well for that. The 20 works really well too, but just so you can get a size in comparison, this is a 1-inch. Right, let me move this over. 1-inch dongle right here, so you can get a sense of scale. Other than that, this does come with the USB-C and A, so you don't have to worry about what type of adapter you need. Okay, so that's that. The first question is from Amazon, and it's as follows. Will this work well for Teams conferencing with multiple voices in the room? It's a great question. So when you have multiple people in a room, you can use different solutions. So the Sync 40 in particular is good for those medium-sized rooms or even larger conference rooms where you want to have multiple people in the room. One of the cool things about the Sync 40 is that you can actually pair it with a second speakerphone and use it in a room, especially if you have a little larger room and you need better coverage for microphone pickup. Otherwise, one Sync 40 is usually very good for a huddle room where you have 4 to 6 people. Or if you're getting above that number, sometimes you may want to use an additional Sync 40 so you get better coverage, both audio as well as for microphone pickup. Great question. Our next question is from Simu. I hope I pronounced that correct. Simu wants to know, why can I connect the Sync 40 speaker to my PC via Bluetooth? Thought that Bluetooth is something that comes with default these days. Well, Simeo, let me answer a few things for you. I think you've got a couple of different thoughts going on here. So the answer is yes, you can connect it via Bluetooth natively, meaning without a dongle. That's usually recommended if you are basically going to just listen to music and, important, and you have your PC and your Sync 40 close to each other. Why is that important? Bluetooth is a signal that's very prone to interference. It is also a weak signal, so that if you have interference, whether it's objects or even other Wi-Fi networks in the area or near you, those things can interrupt the Bluetooth signal. That's why it's recommended, if you're going to be using with a PC, that you use the USB cable that comes with it and connect it to the computer. Otherwise, it is highly recommended. I've recommended this for clients all the time. Go ahead and use that USB dongle. It's going to give you a much more stable and a much better experience, because the dongle provides a dedicated resource for you on that computer. We've covered in previous episodes on the importance of having a good Bluetooth connection. And if you take a look at the links below, we have other episodes going into deeper details about how to make sure you have a good Bluetooth connection with the device you're intending to use. Our next question is a really good one here. Is there any way to turn down the lady's voice who announces when the devices connect or disconnect, etc., like a verbal confirmation, but it's way too loud? Well, let me help you on that one. Let me turn to the close-up cam so you can see how to do that. It's really simple. So on the Sync 40, you've got two buttons, and when it's in idle mode, essentially you're not actively using it, as long as you have it powered on, all you need to do is, as you can hear, I'm gonna take the volume up.
No phone is connected.
And you could hear that it's much louder. It was announced by the lady's voice.
Now, no phone is connected.
Thank you for reminding me, no phone is connected. See, now it's, I'm gonna turn it all the way down, and on the front, on the 40, you have an indicator bar. And as you can see, no phone is, she's much, much lower. So just go ahead and just, if it's too loud, go ahead and take it all the way down. And the next time she talks, her voice is much lower than the default. All right, and that's how you do that. And our last question also comes from Amazon. I have read that there is a Microsoft Teams certified version. Is this version MS Teams certified? Awesome question. This is coming up more and more with people that are working from home or their offices are migrated to Microsoft Teams. So let me tell you exactly what you're going to get with the Sync 40. There is a version that is designed from Microsoft Teams and is certified for Microsoft Teams. On that Sync 40 speakerphone, you'll have an additional button towards the bottom, right around this area here. And you will see the Microsoft Teams logo, and it's a purple button when it's in use. Now, if you are a Microsoft Teams user, you will really want to get this version simply because you have a lot of features on that version that you can utilize with Microsoft Teams. And down below in the links, we have a link to all of the different features that you can use with the Sync 40 and Microsoft Teams that are great little nuggets to save you time when you use Microsoft Teams. Now, for all you other people that are not using Microsoft Teams, there's another version called the UC version of the Sync 40. This stands for Unified Communications. And so if you are a Zoom user, you use other apps like Ring Central or maybe Pandora or SiriusXM or you stream or you YouTube or any of that that's not having anything to do with Microsoft Teams, you'll want to get this version. This just means you'll get exactly the same thing, but you won't get that Microsoft Teams button. So if you are a person that needs to use this with Microsoft Teams, go ahead and get the Microsoft Teams version. And if you're somebody that's never going to use Microsoft Teams, well, go ahead and use the UC version. But in both cases, you can use them with every single app. The difference is the Teams version is certified for Microsoft Teams and out of the box is ready to use with Microsoft Teams. Other than that, they both will work on every app out there. And there you have it. And that's a look at the Sync 40 and the most frequently asked questions on this new Poly speakerphone. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and bump that like button. Join me now in part two, where I answer more questions on the Sync 40 speakerphone. I'll see you there.